नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
हरि ओम। काल कालः, वन हु इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ टाइम और वन हु इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ डेथ ऑल्सो। लिटरली काल काला मीन्स वन हु इज डेथ ऑफ डेथ ऑल्सो। This name of Lord Shiva is referring to the Mrityunjaya Leela when Bhagwan saved Markandeya from Lord Yama. More details about this episode we will take up in the name Mrityunjaya when it comes. Kala literally means time. So the Lord also is the one who is the Karma Phala Data. In our Puranas it is said that there is one person called Chitragupta who keeps an account of all the karmas of every single jiva. And when the time is up, that jiva drops the body. When the time is right, the jiva takes birth. So it is said that the Lord himself is the Chitragupta. And as Chitragupta, he keeps track of every jiva's karma. Appropriate bodies, appropriate environments are given to the jiva to exhaust their karmas. Hence the Lord is Kala. The literal meaning of the word kala is kalayati ganayati iti kalaha. To keep a count is kala. And Bhagwan becomes the Chitragupta and he keeps an account of all the jiva's karma. Every single jiva's karma, Bhagwan keeps a track. And appropriately the jiva gets the environment, the bodies, and also the karmic accounts of different jivas. Bhagwan brings all the jivas also together to interact and exhaust their karmas. So he is Kala. Kala also means events like birth, change, death. All these happen in time. And all these happen by the grace of the Lord alone. Hence he is Kala. It is also said that Bhagwan is Karma Kalavit, the knower of the right time when karmas have to be done. Karmas can mean rituals also. Karmas can mean each jiva. When is the right time for the jiva to get their karma phala? When is the right time for the jiva to do certain karmas? So he is the knower of all these. Karma Kalavit. And as Kala Kala, the death of death also, it is said that Bhagwan controls the Maya under whom even Lord Yama comes. Hence the Lord is Kala Kala. Another name of the Lord is Kala Katankataha, which means the Maya which creates, sustains and destroys is in the control of the Lord. And it is by the grace of that Lord and by the fear of that Lord that all the phenomenal forces also function. In the Upanishads it is said, Bhishasmad Vata Pavate. It is by the fear of that Lord that the wind blows. Bhishodeti Suryaha, the sun rises. Bhishasmad Agnischa Indrascha, even fire and Indra, they are able to do their work because of the fear of the Lord, they do their duties. And Mrityur Dhavati Panchamaiti, even Lord Yama, as though runs and does his duty by the fear of that Lord. And another place in the Upanishad it is said, Mrityuhu Yasya Upasechanam. Death is a pickle for that Lord. For us, death is so terrifying. We lose everything at the time of death. Our near and dear ones, our possessions, everything we are separated from and we are scared of death. But death is scared of the Lord. Why? Because when the pralaya happens, all the devatas merge into the Lord, including Lord Yama also. That Supreme Lord is indestructible. Is imperishable, pure consciousness, existence, consciousness and bliss. That is the nature of the Supreme Lord. Birth and death are a mere appearance or play of this consciousness. Lord Shiva becomes the death of everyone. The entire universe, all the asuras, all the beings in the creation, all the devatas, including Lord Yama. So he is Kala Kala. The Lord of destruction who is indestructible, who is imperishable as pure consciousness. And it is this Lord whom we worship in Ujjain as Mahakal. Kalakal and Mahakal mean the same, the imperishable, indestructible, supreme consciousness. In Avantikapur in Ujjain, we worship the Lord as Mahakal. It's a Jyotirlinga, one of the 12 main Jyotirlingas. How interesting it is that the name of the Lord in Ujjain is Mahakal. Ujjain is the Greenwich of India, or it is called the navel of the earth. It is located where the Tropic of Cancer and the zero meridian of longitude, they intersect. From astrology standpoint also, Ujjain time is what is used for perfect prediction. It is 29 minutes behind the Indian standard time. So our great rishis and masters were not just spiritual people, but they also embedded a lot of science through spirituality. The name of the Lord could have been anything, but it is Mahakal at Ujjain, which means he is the greatest time and death of death. And whoever realizes this tattva, Shiva tattva, also goes beyond death. That's why the great saint Tukaramji said, my death is dead. Because one who realizes the self, one who realizes that I am one with that supreme consciousness, and that is unborn, unchanging, undying, comes to experience this state of immortality. So one more name of Lord Shiva in this connection is Jagat Kala Sthalaha. Lord Yama or death devours the whole world, but Lord Shiva makes Yama as his plate. Sthalaha means plate. So Lord Yama becomes his eating plate. Figuratively, it is to say that Bhagwan is fearless, Bhagwan is indestructible. The supreme consciousness is unaffected by the play of birth and death, which is time. Death is not something that comes at the end of life. Death is every single moment. Ayur nashyati pasyatam pratidinam yatikshayam yauvanam. Every single day, every single moment, we are dying. As body, mind, intellect, we are dying and we are moving closer to the final annihilation. As long as we are identified with the body, mind, intellect, we will have fear of death, fear of loss, fear of pain. But when we meditate on Kala Kala, then we lose all the fear. Why? Because Kala or time is only when our mind is active. When the mind is not active, there is no time. We don't experience time. Our true nature is that consciousness which is the enlivener of the mind. So we cannot be affected by time at all as pure consciousness. So if we shift our identification, we realize that we are Kala Kala. As consciousness, we are Kala Kala. Listen to Pujya Gurudev giving such a beautiful explanation of what is time and how consciousness is beyond time.
Time is the interval between events. Is Einsteinian definition of time. The objective scientists have thought over it and came to the conclusion and became the standard definition of time, interval between events. The Swami came and started talking. Abba, it ended. 1 hour, oof. Somehow or other we lived through it. This is called the measurement of time. The 2 points, 2 intervals, is the interval between 2 events. I went to sleep, got up, then the interval. While sleeping, there is no time. Why? There are no events at all. If events are not taking place for you, you have no concept of time. That is why under chloroform you have no time. In deep sleep, no time. Interval between events is time. The great subjective masters, the rishis, said that events taking place anywhere cannot give me my experience of time. My experience of time will come only interval between events that take place for me. Events outside taking place for me is called my experience. So the subjective masters defined time as interval between experiences. An experience is impossible without a thought. So the interval between thoughts is a measure of time. So from the infinite consciousness, when the first thought rose, there was no time. It was zero time. No? From A to B is 5 inches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 inches. At A, what was the distance?
Zero.
Zero. Then 1 inch, 2 inch, 4 inch, 5 inch. B. When the first thought came, it was zero time. When the second thought other than the first rose, there were two events, first thought experience, second thought experience. Therefore, the concept of time started. That is why time is called not first, but the unit of time is second. You have to say first, second. Because first is zero time. So the unit of time is second, when the second thought rose and I became conscious of it. This great and higher state of consciousness, since it is not conditioned by time, because time is also an object of our consciousness, we are conscious of the flow of time. So the consciousness that is observing and recognizing and experiencing time, time is an object of consciousness. So then, this higher state being not conditioned by time, the destiny of time and things belonging to time are not his. He, the Lord, is not born or dying. Birth and death, beginning and end, is only in the realm of time. All things are born in him, exist in him, and dies and disappears in him.
So in this way, our nature is that pure consciousness. We are truly Kala Kala, and let us worship that Supreme Lord Shiva as Kala Kala. So let us be free from the greatest fear of human life, that is fear of death. Let us meditate more and more on the immortal, indestructible, unborn, unchanging, undying consciousness. Let us realize that we are Kala Kala. We don't have to be scared of Kala if we realize our true self. Kala may be then scared of us. May the grace of Lord Mahakal, Kala Kala, be with all of us and make us fearless.
Om Namah Shivaya. Shivaya.